What's up, guys? Just had to get out of the hospital. I'm about to get settled into my apartment. I'm going to be here for a while. It's close to the doctors, and they have one of these things to get around on. And I keep the foot elevated, and I have this little thing to get around on. Keep a positive mindset. You know, we've got this. Look, here we go this way. We've got this. I had a couple of ups and downs the last couple of days. I had a great birthday yesterday. I appreciate all the birthday messages all you guys sent me. Thanks so much for that. You know, I came out of surgery. I was feeling, you know, very euphoric. The job was done. It was a great job that was done on it. And I was like, yes, I've got this. It's going to be easy. I'm going to do this, no problem. And then I hit a wall. Then I was like, you know, I'm in a lot of pain. My mobility is, you know, I'm going to be like this for a while. It's not going to be a few days or even a few weeks. It's going to be a bit of time. So I kind of went into a little rut after that. But, you know, I know there's going to be ups and downs on this journey that I'm going to be on. And I'm aware of them now. And I'm just a bit more happy, a bit more accepting of it. And, you know, motivated to keep going. Like I said, we got out of hospital on my birthday. Got some fresh air. This is actually the first bit of fresh air I've got since I went into the surgery room. So I'm just gonna breathe this lovely Cali air in. Touch base with the doctors again today and just keep in touch. We're gonna bring the family out in a couple of days to see my kids again. Just keep the head sharp, you know. I've got this. I've got a great team behind me. I want to thank all my team, you know, from my coaches, my training partners, my family, my friends, just everyone that's been supporting me, all my business partners, you know, of course, all the medical staff. I'm just extremely grateful for every single one of you. And I'm motivated to go and do this. And I'm going to do this. I'm going to come back. The leg is better than ever. I was injured going into the fight. People are asking me, when was the leg broke? At what point did the leg break? Ask Dana White. Ask the UFC. Ask Dr. Davidson, the head doctor of the UFC. They knew I had stress fractures in my leg going into that cage. There was debate about pulling the thing out because I was sparring with no shin pads. And I kicked the knee a few times. So I had multiple stress fractures in the shin bone above the ankle. And then I have trouble with the ankle anyway, do you know what I mean? Throughout the years of fucking fighting all the time. So, and I also was wrapping my ankle. I was wrapping my ankle every training session. You know, I even done a lot of training sessions where when the ankle was sore, I still wouldn't stop training. I used to just train on my back. And that's how I developed those ground and pound shots from the back. That's why Dustin backed away. When he was on top of me and I was landing the up kicks and the elbows and all, it's a horrible place to be in. When you're against someone like me, you can't land. It takes so much effort to try and land shots from your top position. And while you're trying to do that and you're losing your energy, you're getting lumped over by downward elbows and vicious up kicks. And it was a skill I developed because I had the damaged leg and I had to adjust my training. So, you know, now I'm essentially at the getting exactly what I needed to get there. I needed to get treatment on my leg. I needed to get treatment on the ankle, and I needed to get treatment on the shin bone. And I would have never committed to going under the knife unless something like this has happened. So something like this has happened. I'm at the going in. I'm at the getting exactly what I needed, and what I needed was a titanium shin bone. So now I've got a titanium rod going down the knee, from the knee to my ankle. And the doctor said it's unbreakable. So once I build back, you know, first of all, manage the incision, the cut, you know, make sure it doesn't get infected, keep the health on it, keep building back that way. Then I'll start playing with the balance, learning how to stand on it again, learning how to balance on the single leg again. Then I'll build the strength. And then I've got an unbreakable titanium leg. I was talking to my physical therapist, Heather, who was with Arnold Schwarzenegger, his other half. And I was saying, I'm like Arnie in Terminator 2. You know what I mean? So I cruise around the Cali streets. Getting a bit of fresh air. and just keeping the head sharp. So I just want to get on, give you a little update. I want to thank you all so much for the messages of support. I appreciate every single one of you. And you know, let's do it. I've also got the Tidal Sport. I'm very happy with the Tidal Sport recovery spray. That's gonna have me back here as well. You know, it's gonna keep the swelling down. You know, once the cut heals and I can put the Tidal on it. So I've got all the tools to do this, and I'm gonna do it, and I'm excited about it. And you know what a story it's gonna be. So let's go, team. Da 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 da. It's the motherfucking DOGG. Love yous all, guys. Love the bones yous all. Let's go. Yous won't stop us. Yous won't beat the Irish. Yous won't beat the Mac Man.